In today's demonstration, we're going to be talking about the common private and public cloud experience for automation. First, we'll be working with our REST APIs. Second, we'll be leveraging the Pure Storage PowerShell SDK. And finally, we'll be wrapping up with our REST client. You can access our REST API directly from the Flash Array Management GUI, which will take you to a page where now you can search and click on all of the various REST API endpoints and exactly how each of them can be used. Here you can see that we're looking at the get array REST endpoint with all of its various parameters, and you can also see that there are examples. What we're going to be doing next is actually using a REST client tool to directly access our APIs. In this case, I'm just using Postman. So there are several different things that we're going to be doing. First is we're going to be getting an API token for authentication. So once we submit this, now we have our API token, which can be seen in the bottom pane. Now what we do with that API token is then go to create a REST session. By creating a REST session, we'll actually get a cookie session, and that is what will be used throughout the other communications that we'll be doing with the get, put, and post operations. And there you can see that there is our cookie for that particular REST session. The next thing we'll do is basically get a retrieval of all the hosts that have been defined on the Cloud Block Store. And here you can see where we have worldwide names, we have IQNs. Next is being able to retrieve all of the volumes from the Cloud Block Store. So you can see times, dates, serial numbers. Next is we'll go ahead and create a new volume. And this is going to be called the Cloud Block Storage Vol, and it'll be created as a 1 terabyte in size. By executing that command, now we can see that we've actually just created a new volume. And the next thing we're going to do is take that new volume and create a new snapshot out of it. You can notice here that it has Cloud Block Storage Vault 1, indicating that that is the first snapshot for that particular volume. Going back into the Cloud Block Store, now we can go ahead and search for those volumes that we created. We can see that there is the Cloud Block Storage Vault. And then by clicking on that, we can also see that there is the snapshot that we've also just created. The next thing that we'll be showcasing is using our Pure Storage PowerShell SDK to perform similar automation tasks that we had done using just the general REST client. Here, we're actually creating a connection to the Cloud Block Store. And if I query that Cloud Block Store variable, you can see that I'm logged in as Pure User. I'm an array admin, and you can even see the API version. Next, we'll go ahead and retrieve all the hosts. And here you can see that these are all the hosts defined. I can now go ahead and get all of the particular volumes on the Cloud Block Store. And then next, I can actually get just information back from one particular volume. Now we'll go ahead and create a new volume. This is just going to be called Cloud Block Store Vol 4. It's 256 gigs in size, and there's all the details about that particular volume. And once again, just like we took a snapshot with the Postman REST client, we can also take a snapshot using the PowerShell SDK. Now, as we come back over to the Cloud Block Store management interface, we can see that there was the new volume that we created. And by clicking that once again, we can see that there's a new snapshot that's been created for that as well. The last part of the demonstration will be showing our Python toolkit, or also known as our REST client. So here I'm just running Python 3, and here we're going to go ahead and import the Python package. And now I'm going to establish a connection to the array. This is how we're going to achieve our authentication and create that session. Now I can go ahead and get the information back from the array showing the revision number, the array name, now, just like we did in the other demos, we'll go ahead and retrieve a host so we can actually see all the detailed information about an individual host. And now we're going to go ahead and pull back the information from that Cloud Block Storage volume that we created in the previous PowerShell demo.
And once again, we'll go ahead and just create another volume. This one is going to be 500 gigs in size. And then there's all the information about that particular volume. The last thing that we're going to go ahead and do is create a snapshot, just like we've done in all the other two segments. And then there's that snapshot that has been taken of that volume. And the last thing that you want to make sure that you do is actually invalidate your session. So here we go ahead and run invalidate cookie, and now that particular REST session has ended. And again, if we go back over to the Cloud Block Store management interface, and we go ahead and query for those volumes and for that snapshot, you'll see that those have all been taken care of.
This concludes the demonstration showing how the cloud experience versus an on-premises experience is the same, whether you're using the FlashArray or whether you're using Cloud Block Store and leveraging all of our different toolkits.